Now I would like to request Colonel Rahul Kumar to deliver a vote of thanks.
Gentlemen, I know it's time for you to move and I won't be here for long between the best part of the day. I just have 3 points, a quick though the gentleman has summarized very well, but after listening to the discussion, very rightly sir, I had that in mind, an incentive on such things work wonders. You don't have to cut down the pay of the driver as mentioned by you, but say that you have the data, if he has saved 600 liters of petrol, you can say next time you come here, you get this incentive for saving 100 liters. You don't have to give him a figure at all and say, and next time you keep on increasing that and increasing the saving as well as the incentive. We tried this out. I am from a telecom industry. My days are over, but still my past experience tells me that. The second point about what was raised on data, this we faced when the computers came in way back in 95, and data is nothing as mentioned by you unless data is converted into intelligence. Simple as that. I don't want data, I want intelligence out of it. And that intelligence depends on what the customer wants, in what way it wants. So anybody saying I'll give you this data is of no use. You give me intelligence out of this data. How you do it, it's your bandobast. The third point was, I don't agree with that you put something in the engine and say that the driver will not know. I have my doubts. Indians are such jugadu people. You do anything, I can challenge that, they will find out, sir. To give you an example, paging, I don't know how many of you are aware of it, started in 95. I was one of the ones who pioneered this in Bangalore, Bombay, Pune and Hyderabad with Motorola. So quickly, what used to happen, the caller used to call and the operator sitting on the computer used to punch in the message and send. So these operators were minimum education 8th pass, Kannada, Hindi and English language they should be able to understand, right? Now we said how to incentivize these guys. Okay, in a day, in your shift, how many messages you receive and send, we will incentivize that operator. So they started, lot of them worked. Suddenly we found that one of the operators is some 300, 400 messages he has sent, which physically is not possible. So we said, yeah, some jugaad he has done. And you will not believe that 8th pass guy, he found out with a combination of keys as to how he can keep sending the messages, which will not go to the customer, but increase his count. Can you believe that? And we were surprised that as engineers, we couldn't find out that, but he did that, right? Another example of this was, when I got into BPO setup, so we said ki we were very happy. We have something known as cradle to death, cradle to grave monitoring system. Now, as the gentleman mentioned, that drivers are annoyed that you are monitoring me, you are doing this, you are doing that. So here also the operator came up, and they were engineers in support here. Ki sir, this is not fair. You are monitoring each and every move of us. So cradle to grave reporting is, the moment you come and log in, till the time you log out, all your movements will be recorded. How they will be recorded? If you go for coffee break, there is a code, you have to press that. So your records will show coffee break. When you come back, you log in again, that much time will be seen. If you are not logged in, right, you say, okay, I'll not log in and sit and chat. That is again recorded. Basically, all your movements are monitored. So they said, sir, this is not fair, and how can you do that in this? So here again, we said, well, we are not going to cut down anything on that. But when it comes to incentivizing you, you will be at a handicap with the guy who's logging in at most of the time. So basically what we want, we get our share. I have been hired for 1,000 rupees. I am getting 1,000. But where I like to achieve is to go higher and get another 100 rupees. One, in terms of financial help. Second, I think you can design something where you elevate him from a driver to a senior driver or a team lead. So if a guy knows, let's say there are 10 drivers, 20 drivers, out of which two of them understand what benefit this automation is bringing, you make them the head of the other 10 and say, okay, you monitor these guys, you control these guys. So he has some power, he has some incentive to work with those drivers, and the drivers will also listen to him better than the manager there. I feel that, because they are at the same level. This happens in the industry of operators also. An operator comes here, he has no incentive. He knows he will not be promoted because of his qualification or whatever it is. But if you give him as a team lead, we call a team lead, okay, this is your team of 7 or 8 or 10 people, and you control them while you are monitoring him also, that's an incentive. That's an additional point of it. Thank you so much, sir. I would like to thank all the speakers, the panelists, and also the sponsors. And last but not the least, Kritika for doing a good job. We have cocktails and drinks and cocktails outside for you. Please do have, though I don't advise drinking and driving together. So those who are driving their vehicle, please take care. Others can enjoy. We have that at two places, one under the staircase, and the other bar is on the right side where the lunch was there, at the end of the hall. Thank you so much.